Hi guys, it's me, Justin, again, and I would like to wish everyone a very happy and safe Veterans Day for 2023. And this is supposed to be for the veterans that are still with us, and you can still enjoy the company. And still enjoy their stories and have good time with them. No, fortunately, I have no people in my life that have been in war. Now that war changes people, as well as in this movie I'm going to show you right now that the people in the movie are. Of course, the actors, but they show how what happens is like army boot camps and stuff. In this case, the Marines. So I'm sorry if I messed that up a little bit, but it's all Marines in this movie. So let me just pay my respects to all those people that have won. Yeah, I do respect the military. I respect all the people who give their lives for the ultimate cause. And I give, the community ultimate sacrifice. And, they're ready to give their lives for the cause. Whether it be right or wrong. In this case, I'm talking about the Vietnam War. And I don't think that it was a just cause. That war was really, really messed up in so many ways. But I'm about to talk about one of the movies that it's very well made and very good. Stanley Kubrick's Full Metal Jacket. Now, I'm what you call a Stanley Kubrick fanboy because I like his work a lot. So I've seen 2001: A Space Odyssey and the sequel, as well as Orange. These were my favorite movies. I've also got the book which I haven't read yet. I like Spartacus, AI, Eyes Wide Shut, as well as other movies by him. But this movie is fascinating because I took a few classes in psychology at New Paltz. One of the good things I can say about the college is it always says something because it sucks. But I'll be releasing some videos to you guys eventually on that topic. That's why I think it sucks. And it's much more than say, this teacher doesn't like me, he gave me an A- or something. Or, this professor doesn't like people in their chairs, so they can suck it. No, I mean, this school really, really is awful. I mean, really, really bad for those disabled, like me. Disabled characteristics. But more on that later. Much later. So to perfect a few things with my videos. And boy is it gonna be something nice. Anyway, this movie is very special because it shows the programming of humanity into what many would consider a killing machine, or a blank, a tabula rasa, if you will, a blank slate, because it takes away, in boot camp, Marines, the Army, the Navy, the I'm assuming the Air Force too. The soldiers there have to be trained, beaten to death, and yelled at and stuff like that to take away their personality, to take away their value as a human being, so that the value can be used more properly in a war type setting, in combat, and to take words and to be ready to face those people who want to kill them, want to take their lives, they have to beat the people that want to kill them before they do the job. And this movie does it to a T, because it shows how one drill sergeant, played by the Army, the legendary Lee Ermey, shows how he beat these people to death, pretty much. But one of them snaps. One of them is Golden Pyle. And played by Vincent D'Onofrio. In other words, the guy from Men in Black that played Edgar, the roach man. The man with the roach inside his body and stuff. And this movie is a masterpiece of I like to tell. And the phrase "born to kill," it's in Joker's helmet in here. This is the reason why it becomes so important later on. But anyway, they show the boys getting ready for boot camp in the Marines. Now, I don't know if at this point in war history that the United States made it so that women can also join the armed forces. But for right now, I think only men do. So there's that. So then they all have to shave their heads. Kind of a demeaning way to do it. I always thought that the armed forces did that to eliminate individuality and make it so that everyone was on equal footing as far as the looks go. But it's much more simple, it's much more of a simplest thing than that they do to remove headlights, or potentially headlights, which I think the good shampoo would fix a problem, but I guess with the Marines, they gotta do quick. So, that's why they do with that thing. Plus, I'm sure wear shampoo would probably be more of there are probably people that have allergies to government issue shampoo, so that's why a safe reason why they do it like this. Anyway, he took Lee Ermey in his most famous role ever, drill sergeant, which is really funny because before acting, this guy was a real drill sergeant. So that's why whenever he makes stuff up on the spot like that, and various insults and stuff, that's why he does that's why he sounds so convincing. My favorite are, how tall are you? I think he's 5'9", or something like that. Then he says, I know he stacked shit that high. among other things too, is another good one was you're from Texas, only Steven and Chris come from Texas, and I haven't seen any Hawaiians. That's really funny. But you know, something that isn't funny is that he said that he does discriminate against niggers at WAPS types, whatever. But that's funny because they run that in the movie when somebody comments that he doesn't believe in the Virgin Mary. Which one? It says that no, I don't believe in the Virgin Mary and stuff, which means that he's probably Jewish or Muslim for all intents and purposes. But to which the drill sergeant has a fit with that. And he's yelling at the guy more. To which it was funny because the guy says he said that if I backtrack and change my mind, Joseph will dig you up me more. That's very funny. And the fact that he said that Gilman Powell, he says that I will rip off your neck and shit. I will rip off your head and shit down your throat. And then you just choke yourself on my hand. Choke yourself. So then you choke yourself like this. And then he said, no, stupid. I want you to choke yourself on my hand. Don't reach out for my hand. Put your hand toward mine. So he does it. It's really, really funny. Now, I should say that the character of Golden Power is going into the Marines. I don't know why, but he's going into the Marines to fight the war. Now, there's something wrong with Golden Power. I don't know whether it's because he's stupid, or because he's a little bit mentally slow, but he doesn't perform well at most of his tests and stuff. And the exercise to do for the Marine, he can't do properly, like the obstacle course, and like go over the high bars and doing chin-ups. How I can do chin-ups better than I'm in a wheelchair. But the funny thing that the drill sergeant does is since he rides them so hard and since he picks on them a lot, he makes march in like with his pants pulled down. And I did get sucked in from too. Which is very funny. And we're like, of course, childish to show how stupid he is. But another thing that he does that's not right is that he piles to the donut from the mess hall, which is a big no-no in the drill sergeant's mind. So he made sure to have Gum Powell be like the example for everyone to follow, you know, for everyone to be good or else you're gonna get your shit like this guy. And the thing is that when he mistreated, he's whenever he does something bad, Jules Sergeant blamed everyone else for not taking gun power the right way of doing things. You know, trying to shoot lasers, you know, holding the gun properly, you know, doing this, doing that, and this, that. So, every time he screws up, they get the blame and they have to do more work for it because of his slowness. To the point that, the Jewel Sergeant has the Private Joker, the owner of this helmet, you know, some street and be the caretaker, if you will. Now, he also takes Joker and makes him into Captain Team, the Krypton Squad, which is taken over by from Private Snowball, the only black guy in the group. Now, this is kind of weird because, number one, Joker treats him nicely. He referred to him by his first name, Leonard. He tried to humanize the guy, but make it proud and stuff, saying, good job, Leonard, good job, and that's how you do it and stuff. But Leonard is still kind of slow. So, what the rest of the team does is they all take the tube socks, put soap in it, hold the big guy down, and beat him senseless when he's sleeping. It'll be kind of like a bullying thing. So he's getting it from the drill sergeant, and he's getting it from the teammates. Which isn't right, because, you know, this guy is obviously tries hard, but he's obviously got it. Issue with doing with Funk orders being in the Marines and stuff. So, the proper procedure would be to put him in that workshop category where he would lead the team, the company, and just be on his merry way, would do whatever he wants to do in civilian life. But not the dual sergeant rep. Rides hard until the teammate until it just snaps from the sugars off his head. Where, probably become like the best sharpshooter ever. Now, this is bad because when he snaps, number one, the chimera is what happens at the end of the movie where they go up against a sniper at the end. But when he snaps, you know, at graduation day, the last teacher that day with Joe Sergeant, he goes on like a mad spree where his mind just twists and turns in pieces and then snaps in two. Kind of like Mr. Grimm from Twist Metal Black. Perfect example. That's the war, the Vietnam War, and everything else, too. So, we do that. And then, part of the pile is in the bathroom, they have the army come and yell more at Private Pile. And Joker is over there with warning the drill sergeant that he's got live ammunition in his gun, in his rifle. Now, this is extremely hazardous. So what do they do? They'll do some more. And I like the way he says, for the gentleman to get there, he says, if you keep going on like that, being a world of shit, then private pile and a very twisted look on his face of, I am in a world of shit. Because of all the bullying and all the drilling on by the drill sergeant. And mentally so, you know, the dream is shit. Anyway, they showed that. And then, when he's in the middle of the Yona pile, he said, now give me the gun, give it to me right now. So he shoots him right in the chest here, right in the center, killing him instantly. And right after he got that, cleaning the bathroom, begins follows. So, that's the word. He shoots him in the mouth, give him a nice little bullet sandwich. Now, this is a good example of how people in Vietnam, in the Vietnam War, snapped. You know, we see countless examples of people actually going to war or in the war. They can't handle it, what they get out of it, both in what they have to do there, and when they get back, the responsible people, your average Joe's, if you will, know, baby killer, you know, you kill a bunch of kids and all that stuff. They don't know what they went through. But, it's kind of tragic. I mean, I know that some of the parts in the beginning were actually funny, but it was actually really, really heart-wrenching to hear that, this kind of stuff happens. I mean, we've seen it in real life with tragic news stories and stuff. In the book, On Combat and On Killing, which I read pre-psychology major. So, yeah, that's it. Now, the next part of the movie takes place in Vietnam, or was supposed to be Vietnam, and the way it filmed it. It's a completely different part of the movie. It's a completely different half. You got the part where they rip out the humanity of the soldiers by coming and drilling them and drilling them and drilling them and drilling them and insulting them all the time. To where the guy even said, you're no longer turds anymore. Or maggots, any turds. But, yeah. Now it gets on into a funny moment again. Because this gives the hookers and funny ones too. And played by, I think, Mao Papillon Soso. I apologize for the name, but whatever. She, the two lines that until every Asian woman probably hates to the core, and that is trying to pick up the American GIs. She says, "Me love you long time," and then me so horny. Now, I would never say that to an Asian woman, probably because I don't want to get put in my ass. But it's damn funny when she's trying to hook and get these guys. I'll do anything you want. It's so horny. But it's very funny. And she even flutters her butt to them too. Which, again, it's very funny. Now, If you really want to hear something really annoying, my friend of mine that was in Vietnam says it even more obnoxiously. He says, "Me so funny," and "Me love you long time, Tony." And hilarious. But that's the only guy talk now. I would never do this in front of your friends. Especially not Asian women, because they deserve more respect than that. But anyway, after they deal with that woman and the barbed wire and stuff, I don't think they actually do anything else with her, like I, you know, has sex with her and pulled her back. It's funny. But they also introduce other colorful characters like April, which is the only major black guy in the movie. Now, they also introduce a heavy guy. And what I mean by that is big, muscular, and wields a heavy machine gun. So, that's what I refer to as a heavy guy. Not that or anything. This guy's good. This guy's big. But the thing is that during the main part of the movie, during the next part of the movie, with the hooker, and they show the guy bargaining with the woman. He was trying to get a little action there by saying about he got a black Alabama mistake, meaning down there. And she said, "Subuku." Now, for anyone who learned French 4 years like me, know that buku means big or many. And that's referring to, never mind. So she said, she takes a look at it. She said, "Okay." So we got the pimp that runs her. So I thought, "No, we trade the guns for, you know, guns that haven't been fired but dropped once. You know, we'll treat that for $5 to do anything that you want for her, with her." To which he pulled the, you know, the album thing, and then the guy says that, the heavy guy says that, "But we always have to wait, you know, until white man goes somewhere." So he pushes her into the hotel room, and that don't see anything else. Now, you know, pimping hoeing is not okay by any means. But it's funny during the conversation that they had with her in the pimp. Now, it's funny that in the last part of maybe it showed that April gets shot by a sniper. A damn good sniper too. He loads him out. Anyway, this heavy guy that was raised towards the black guy was actually one of the first guys to go propose to get him out of there and pull him out after being hit by the sniper twice or times. So, you can be raised all you want, but when certain things happen, when lives are on the line, you tend to be, kind of give up all that rich bullshit Now, the funny thing is that the show is Huey's, the helicopter type that they use to fly around and stuff, and many vectors and play drops and things like that. But the I don't like the design of the chopper because, you know, everything is fine and dandy. I'm not a helicopter expert, but they have the exhaust fan for the chopper, and it blows right into where the guys will get out, right where the cock hole is. So it's kind of weird to get the exhaust smoke coming from the chopper, and it blows right in your face, right in the open cut, right in the open passenger spots. And also, this heavy guy is very anti-Vietnamese, because I know that war was going on, and Vietnamese like used guerrilla warfare, and that they shot they used to dress up like civilians, and they used to attack soldiers and put razor blades on food and stuff that they gave to soldiers and things. But still, you know, he was overly happy about shooting random people with his machine gun in the helicopter. He would shoot women working in the field, the oxen they were using, to shoot children, men, women, children, whatnot, everybody. Which is not right for any war, you know, to shoot, just randomly shoot the people because the entire country is on it. Against you. You know, the racist thing is just pure civilians, and you could go for war crimes for that. It'd be like us getting into another war with Japan, and us attack all Japanese people, all because the war is against the government. Or to China, or one of the European countries, or whatever. And that's why the war was so sticky. The apocalypse now did a good job with that, with this woman that was very you couldn't tell who was the good guy. Which one is the bad guy? They call him the Viet Cong and Charlie, among other names too, which I probably can't say on YouTube. I got into trouble watching the N-word. But maybe they show random between people to how he's anti everybody over there. And then they do the thing where they shoot a bunch of bad guys, you know, Viet Cong soldiers and stuff, go underground and things. And they also show this one fight with the sniper. Now, they're going to a ruined city, very costly and stuff. And then it won't go down, being shot twice by a sniper in a building. And the guy goes to him, and as he's dragging away the body, he gets shot by the same person. Now, the sniper is obviously well skilled, well trained, just like Golden Pile was back in boot camp. They do something really stupid. They don't use smoke grenades, number one. Number two, if they have a well trained sniper in the area, possible two or three, would it make sense to go after your front comrade using some kind of a mobile cover? Or can they just use like a, the guys to get some kind of a mobile, a corridor or loose piece of stone or something to be a mobile piece of cover so that no other people get shot and killed by the sniper. The sniper is really good because she takes out a bunch of the guys that go behind the building, and then they shoot she shoots one of the commanders through a wall, a whole wall, while he's talking to somebody on the phone. Big ass brick like phone with them. Good. This is my cell phone now. This is about your average cell phone. But the one that they use for phone work is about maybe twice the length of this. I'm trying to hear. I'm like, that's just that. Give me function to bed. I think of this phone with no functions other than the cell phone. So it was it was dark ages, like I'll admit that. But much everyone's crying and yelling and stuff, and then you just don't need to get around to her. Now, it's funny that he shot in the side of his belly and then died right there. But the funny thing, when he showed her scoping through and he can't target himself, the guy ends up of course dying, but they also show another soldier there next to him with his head up, for a good target. I would think that the sniper girl would shoot for it if this guy that's there with his head up exposed and kill him that way. Now, remember how I mentioned about two girls before that they were grown women, and that it was really quite kind of a sporadic hidden state of those things. But then it was even more shocking when you find out that the sniper is a little girl, a little school girl actually. She probably gets training that goes to school in the next hour or so. And it's really weird to see this trained sniper being a little girl. Well, the spread aspect of this war that you didn't know who was good and who was bad. So then they end up sneaking up on her. Joker ends up trying to kill her by her. His wife gets jammed. A very bad situation. I kind of remember Jay Vlog death in the Mars attack. But this is much more serious because she ends up pulling a gun on him, tried to shoot him, gets comrades, and then he ends up one of the other guys makes her dance with the machine gun fire. Almost kills her. Either paralyzed or left for dead, pretty much. It's really tragic because they show a young kid like that, 12 years old, saying a prayer. Now, this prayer is, I don't know what it is like. It might be just gibberish and Vietnamese or whatever, but it's really, really, really tragic. See, the young girl beats a good sniper and then dies. They're paralyzed. So then, the guys are like, they have a question to answer. Do we put this girl out of misery? Or do we let her rot and let the rest eat her alive and cause her more suffering than she caused her friend before they were killed by her? Personally, I would just kill her. I would just kill her part of my misery. That'd be the good thing. That'd be the good thing to do. And you see this wound kill? Yeah, that comes in handy because Joker is the one who kills her. After all, she said, shoot me. Multiple times in every voice. Now, we all know what this means, that she wants to be killed. You know, she wants to be part of her misery. She wants to join her ancestors in the afterlife or whatever. But could also mean something sexual, something derogatory for people who are like in the industry. So it could also look back to the thing with the hookers. Also, just a matter. The girl is called up. Another derogatory term for Vietnamese women is mom san. And the guys use the term for girl too. They refer to her as baby san. I don't know what her real name is in the movie, but I think it's played by Lee Nak. Her name is Lee Nak. So, she's a very good actress. So, they give the guy Joker the opportunity to kill her or let her suffer, which eventually kills her. Now, it's also mirrors back of legend. I'm just reading the back of the cover here. You have all those Howard. Matthew Modine, Animal Mother. Animal Mother, but I'm Baldwin. So, you have Dorian Hart. I will. Anyway, they also have, they also do look small, but yeah, I'll cover that in a minute. So, this show, how these people become desensitized to war. How they train the experience. They did, and trained it, you know, it's basically, other humanity basically stood then. And said to the world compared to everyone involved that when they snap, when the PTSD comes in, that's when it can be dangerous to people. Anyway, then we get into it by the written song. All these songs, the soundtracks are good, but that's not kind of weird because they have the Roman scene, the Mickey Mouse theme song, you know, the MISKYMOUSE, and then they pull it up, and it's something because they have, guys singing the beat, kind of like, of course, we all know that Disney Corporation is like a non-stop thing. It's like a hungry giant that never gets tired eating and it's growing and growing inside. And it's very powerful and stuff. Meaning they consume other things, the pizza signs. And that song said that to tea. But then if you think about it, the US was trying to influence Vietnam. And frankly, it's like that because we lost the war. The war also showed, you know, how we're not invincible. The US does make errors. It can't win every war, especially guerrilla warfare, which is the reverse of what happened in the American Revolution when we used guerrilla warfare against a much more regimented British. I'll get into that some other day. But using the song, it showed the ever increasing amount of influence the United States and capitalism had in Vietnam and China and other places like that. Communism as an economic and political basis. The movie ends with that, with Painted Black by HGT. Now, they also use the tongue. These boots are made for walking, and they did the hooker scene, the French hooker scene. As well as other stuff too. Now, this movie is incredible. I love it. It showed the dehumanization of soldiers, what they go through in war, among many other things too. I definitely recommend to anyone who wants to see a good war movie. But there is a swing and there is violence. There is everything else that we expect from a war movie. So, thank you for watching my video on this format jacket. If you guys have any more suggestions to me, you can always contact me on my cell phone and call me or text me at 631-707-3707. And if you want, you can come to me on Twitter or actually prefer it under the named at PNelson Pro. Also, you can get me on my email account at you email me directly at jhvshow@gmail.com. And don't forget to leave a comment, share, like, and subscribe to my channel. So, I salute all troops of America. And, God bless America, all the troops. And, I'm not pro war, not pro getting people killed and stuff. The policy failures and stuff like that. So, yeah. And I love that right now. But, yeah. Enjoy my other videos. And I'm going to do another video movie involving the Vietnam War. Anyway, this movie is a masterpiece. And agree with me, or if you don't, then we'll comment below. So, this movie's great. You definitely see it. And I'll see you next one. Aloha and happy Veterans Day.